like I know I'm a bodybuilder, and I know it's something I do professionally. I still don't really even see myself entirely as a bodybuilder. There's a lot of times now where people will talk about being Mr. Olympia. You know, they like to throw that term around and say, "Well, you know, you're trying to be Mr. Olympia." And I'm thinking to myself, "Well, wait a minute, who said that? I don't even know if that's my goal." Which sounds funny because you're competing at the Mr. Olympia contest. What the hell would you be there for if you don't want to be Mr. Olympia? Because I never thought about it in terms of that. I always just thought about it in terms of the next show and showing progress and just I don't know, just do it. Just it's something I felt compelled to do, and I just did it, and I'm just kind of going through it. And whatever happens, happens.
Time that we see, you know, him, you know, that he can get another rep, or that, you know, he can do something a little harder, go a little heavier, like we're there to give him that extra, like, go ahead, you know, like you'll see him, he'll rest, pause during things, and, you know, we'll tell him to keep it going, and just that extra push that you need, because sometimes when you're by yourself, not saying that, you know, about Evan or anything, but sometimes when you're by yourself, you don't know what you're, you know, well, your pinnacle is like, what more can you do to challenge yourself? But if somebody else is telling you to keep going, or to, you know, go past that pain barrier, then you do it, you know? So we're here to like push him and help him to go past what he normally thinks he can go.
I think that's just like, oh, I gotta eat again. I gotta eat some carbs off this cardio.
Another, you know, a large advantage I have this year for getting ready for the Olympia is that I have a really good, you know, group of guys that I'm training with on a daily basis. You know, I have Mark Andrade, who I was training with last year, and I now have Jeff Logan, who's a part of our group now. And the three of us together, you know, I mean, no one can make you go harder or do the things you're supposed to do. And in truth be told, you know, training, as important as it is, it's only a small part of the process as a whole. So, I mean, that being said, training right now is better than ever, because I have their support, because I'm able to feed off of their enthusiasm. And I'm also held to maintaining a certain standard, you know, being the most advanced one in the group. It forces me to say, okay, well, you know, these guys are looking to me to set an example, and I have something to live up to, not only for myself, but also, you know, to them. So I gotta show them what it is, you know, to be a pro, and what that means, and how a pro handles his business. So it definitely, it keeps you a little more honest.
Both fans before we started training with him, so we both knew of his physique, we knew of him, we knew how he trained. So just being a part of it and watching it from first-hand view every day, we can see the differences in a year, how it's come up, how it's body up.
One day me and Mark, we both had shirts on, you know, we both had Universal shirts on with Evan in it, and we realized like, wow, we both had shirts on with Evan in it, like, you know, like
in the shirt.
and we trained with him, and then also we're in the hotel room with him, you know, day before the Tampa Pro, and you know, we're in here every day, and we're not talking to him from a fan point of view. even though we're still fans, but at the same time, you got to tell them, hey, you're looking a little flat, or you're looking tight, or you have to be very honest with him, you know? And that's what he needs from him, honesty and like...
It's tough to be honest with someone you look up to, but I feel like a lot of bodybuilders, you see them on stage and they're like, does he have no friends to tell him that he doesn't look ready?
Right.
But obviously that's not the case with Evan, but us being there and telling him that, I feel like he brought his physique a long way.
Like I said, having their support, I mean, these guys, they show up every day, they don't complain, they do whatever is asked of them, and they're training so hard, you know, for their own purposes. The Mark's getting ready for nationals, Jeff's getting ready for his first competition, and like I said, probably the greatest gift they give me, aside from the support that they give on a daily basis, is the enthusiasm that they share with me and that I'm able to feed off of. And that's worth a lot. I mean, that might sound cheesy, and that might not sound a lot, but like a lot, but it sincerely is.
I mean, I was just awestruck by just how I couldn't even think someone would be that size. And this is when he just turned pro, I believe, at Nationals. So he was a big dude. And I actually started competing because of him. I heard that he was also a former fat kid that changed his life. And after I transformed myself and I wanted to get into competing, I felt like he was the main inspiration for me as far as bodybuilding goes. I mean, I knew about Arnold and stuff like that, but the modern day bodybuilder, I didn't know much about him. He was probably the only one I knew. And it's still surreal being able to work out with him. I never thought that I'd be at this point ever, but a lot of us think that way, and then when it comes true, it's just a surreal moment. You know, it's just, you don't take it for granted.
No, you can't.
You work hard, you show up, you don't complain.
This is Chris Tuttle here, good friends with Evan Centopani. Used to train with them back in 09, 010, 011, 012. I'm just gonna hear talk a little bit about how I think Evan's changed over the last 5 or 6 years with his training, nutrition, mindset, and one thing that's different, I think, from Evan, from most people, is so many people get caught up in doing the same thing with the same result, or doing the same thing expecting a different result. Obviously, Evan's had a great success in what he's done with nutrition, what he's done with training, and it has paid off. I think over the years, you know, trial and error, he tries new things, see what works. But I think the biggest changing point was Olympia last year. You know, he's always done, you know, he pretty much done his own nutrition, his own training. And I feel that, like, at that point, he may have come to an understanding that maybe, you know, there might be something else more, something else better, which most people have a lot of time, difficult time doing that, changing, looking outside the box, seeking help, looking at things different angles. Because let's be honest, there's always a better way. There's always new things. There's always some type of training style, nutrition that's going to work for different people. And I think Evan is an innovator. He's definitely not a copycatter, that is for sure. Since I've known him, one thing I respect the most about him is he definitely marched to the drum of his own beat. And I think, like, with nutrition and training now, I think he views things in a little bit of, you know, he looks past of what he's got and maybe trying to change a few things here and there. I remember for a while, we used to train pretty heavy. I mean, I remember go up to like 6 plates on squats for like 8-10 reps, no belt, no knee reps, barefoot, wearing dress socks. And I remember he had some knee problems for a while. The knees were, you know, knees just get achy, as of anybody's knees when they do heavier squats. And there's a little more pre-exhaustion, a little more focus, a little higher reps on things. But I think the new Evan's focus is
is great. I think we're moving in a whole new direction. I think the possibility of Evan making substantial gains the next 2 to 3 years is very likely. Just because of his mindset, I don't really know many people who have that type of always moving forward mindset. There's not much stepping back or staying stagnant for too long, where you see some people who just, they stay the same place for so long and they never get it. And it's one of those situations where you see some people who are like, if they just did this, they would be great, but they never do. And Evan's definitely not one of those people, and that's what's gonna separate him from a lot of other people, and I think he will surprise people. And the funny thing is, and it's, you know, obviously he knows a little bit more than I do about this whole thing, is I still think that he hasn't really gotten that 100% yet. I don't think, some people might be like, oh, this is probably as good as Evan's gonna get or a little better. I think Evan could probably get a lot better. And I think because of his mindset and innovation and his ability to look outside the box and seek help when needed, is going to, you know, basically it's like sky's the limit. It's gonna keep going, going, going.
He does have that nastiness. He does have that conditioning that, you know, can't be touched, and his posing got better. And I mean, when he came out in Tampa, the whole crowd was quiet. You know, it was like they were in awe of him. And he is his own, you know, best critic. And it's like, he wants to bring the best Evan there. And he's not gonna get psyched out about, you know, this guy's doing it, this guy's doing it. No, no, no. If he brings the best Evan there, it's gonna be tough to beat.
I've always known Evan to do it for the love of training. You know, from the very get-go, he's never really done it for the competition aspect of it. He just loves to train. He's very, very intense. He's very, very driven. I think it's just a matter of improving his physique year in and year out. And the competition, you know, pretty much is a byproduct of that. You know, I think, you know, he does it for the love. He does it, you know, for, you know, just the improvement. And then whatever happens in the competition, he brings it in. And I think because of that, he's bringing the intensity and just the pure joy onto stage from, you know, the love of doing it, you know? He's never been competition driven. He's never been that way. Sure, does he want to win the Mr. Olympia? Absolutely, absolutely. Do we all want him to win? Absolutely. And the fact that he comes in day out, okay, day in and day out, with the drive and the intensity that he puts on that gym floor, okay, you know, just shows every second of his love for it.
I'm 31, which isn't old by any means, and even in the bodybuilding world, you know, most guys are hitting their stride, hitting their full peak in their mid to late 30s. So I think there's plenty of time left in the sport of bodybuilding. Should I choose that? You do start to ask yourself, you know, how much longer will I go, or when will I know that it's time for me to move on? Basically, you're always kind of thinking down the road. And although it's impossible to plan, I think it's impossible to plan for the future, you kind of, I guess, you try to develop some type of rough image of what you see your future looking like. Probably the best I've been able to come up with is that I'll feel like it's time to leave bodybuilding when I feel like I've accomplished everything I can accomplish. Now, does that mean, in terms, you know, is that a reflection on competitive success? You know, could I say, well, if I place fifth at the Olympia and I don't feel I'll ever do better than that, does that mean it's time to retire? Or does it mean that I've gotten to the point where I don't feel like I'm contributing anything to the lives of those around me, and I'm not further enhancing my own life? Is it time to move on then? I guess that's probably what makes more sense, is do you leave bodybuilding, or do you leave anything else in life? Is it time to start something else when you feel like maybe it's not fulfilling anymore? You could be doing more for yourself, more for your family, more for humanity. I don't know. Maybe you just wake up one morning and say, fuck, I'm bored with this. I've had enough of it. I'm ready to do something else. So I'm assuming when it's time, I'll know. I haven't felt that way yet. No, I don't ask questions. I'll just keep going.
We wanted to go more of an epic music way where he could really show strength, confidence, and just pure power out there. And he achieved that. And so that's basically what we're looking for to bring into the Olympia, is a nice, strong, confident Evan to match his physique.
Pretty much, I think the improvements from Tampa, or just even last year's O, you know, being a week out right now, is just fullness. I'll say a lot of fullness, you know, same tightness, but it's fuller. You know, he's going to present a bigger illusion on stage. You know, the side shots is better, front double by is better. Just, I think everything is just better. It just came up. I'll say the big, you know, changeover is fullness.
I said to him, I don't even want to see how you look. I'm waiting to prejudge him because I want you to unleash it, because that's how good he looks.